Everyone in this arena has a money stake in one of our famous couples. The red section has its money on Dick Gauthier and his wife, Barbara Stewart. The yellow section backs Greg Morris and his wife, Lee. And the blue section is betting on Jerry Stiller and his wife, Ann Mira, as we play the game of celebrity gossip, Tattletale. And here's the star of Tattletales, Bert Convy.
Oh, you're new. You don't know that I do that. You didn't know that. Oh, I always kiss. You know it now. It's right. Hi, everybody. Welcome to Tattletales. Nice to have you with us. We have three wonderful celebrity couples, and they're going to win some money for their rooting sections. Right, gang? Of course not. Let's start off by having our ladies out here with me. Fellas, if you will, step to the back room, and we shall return to start our first round of Tattletales. In just a moment.
It's time to go all or nothing.
Survey said.
For Buzzer Casino.
Let's see if you get lucky.
It's a place where luck meets drama.
Is it escargot? It is too.
And fortunes are made.
Well, you'll have a good time.
We're laying odds that a different game show every week.
Never have you been so lucky.
Will hit the jackpot.
I'm a gambler at heart, especially when it's not my money to start with.
Meet us on the Buzzer Casino floor weeknights at 10. Buzzer Casino. Feeling lucky?
Oh, you bet.
Hello, we're back, ready to start our first round. Let's meet everybody paired up again, shall we? First is the lovely Ann Mira and her husband, Jerry Stiller.
Hello. Hello, everybody.
The blue section is rooting like mad for you, Jerry. You ready to go?
Oh, I'm all aghast.
Always, I can see that.
Yeah, but
next to them, our newcomers on the show is Greg and Lee Morris.
Right.
It's nice to have you with us first time. You're all rookies, but don't get up tight about that, because we welcome everybody. No problem with that. Greg and Lee, nice to have you with us. Next to you is Barbara Stewart and her husband, Dick Gauthier.
Hey!
Oh, that's nice.
How are you, Bert?
I'm fine. Richard and you, sir.
Terrific.
Well, yeah. We'll see about that.
What? What? Do you know something?
The red section is waiting. All right, ladies and gentlemen. I'm now going to ask the ladies some questions about them and you, your husbands, and your lives together. When you have an answer you think he's going to recognize back there, then press that button in front of you. But you have to be quick. I'll only take one answer. Okay?
Either I'm going blind or the false eyelash is stabbing.
No, it's all right. Okay. It's all right.
Oh, no, it's fine. It's your
Thank
eye
you.
That's coming up.
I see. He's a wonderful person.
Okay, fellas, we're going to cut you off now. We'll be back in just a moment.
Yes.
Okay. Bye. All right, ladies, ready to go?
Yes.
Here comes the first question. Your first date. Barbara. Oh. Boy, are you fast, Barbara.
Am I? That's what...
And you press that button quickly,
No, I won't say it. I won't say it. Throw it in my mouth.
Go ahead.
Yes, Bert.
Tell us about your first date,
well,
Fasty.
Well, our first date was a blind date. Because the studio fixed it up. We were doing a television pilot. And we got these tickets for Mutiny on the Bounty at the last minute. And I wasn't going with anyone in particular at that time. And I needed a date, so the studio sent over this fellow that I was going to be doing the show with. So when he opened the door, I almost fell down because I thought, my gosh, I really hit the jackpot. I mean, this terrific-looking fellow. I couldn't believe it. Unfortunately, his tuxedo didn't fit. My dress was too tight. So all night now, we go to see Mutiny, and we're sitting there, and he's tugging on this, and he's tugging on this, and on his pants legs, and my bra broke. Luckily, I was still young at the time.
Oh, yeah. Give her a hand, folks. I don't know if that's a hand out of sympathy or what.
No, it's
understanding.
It's understanding, that's
right.
What it
they
is.
They all know what that is. Anyway, we had such a fantastic time. We stayed out till 4 in the morning, and I really adored him, and I thought he adored me, and he didn't even try to kiss me. Not only that, I didn't see him again for 3 months.
Oh, my.
That's right.
So the first date would be what?
A big bust, that's what
Yes, that's what you said earlier, as a matter of fact. That's what Dick said. It's funny that you should say that. We need a one or two word clue now that Dick will recognize.
How about blind?
Okay.
I hope he doesn't think that means drunk. Blind.
Your first date and...
No, mutiny, mutiny. You're right, mutiny.
Can you go with that? All right, the man says we can. A one-word clue worth $100 to your rooting section, and the clue is mutiny. Let's bring on the fellas. Gentlemen.
Yes.
We have asked the ladies a question, and we have a clue. So
I should hope so.
Sound that signal when you think you recognize her and can match her story from the clue. Here is the question first. Your first date. Okay?
Yeah.
The clue is mutiny. Dick.
What else could
that
be? All
right, Richard, tell us about your first date, sir.
Well, we were going to do a pilot together, and Barbara's ticket goofed at the last moment or something. Anyway, what finally ended up was someone set us up on a blind date to go see the premiere of Mutiny and the Bounty. Not the first one. We're not that old.
Thank you. We had a lot of laughs along the way there, Dick. And,
yeah, I had a lot of laughs that night, too, Bert.
I bet you did. Anyway, you scored 100 points. We'll get back with the next question.
I scored 100. I scored that night.
All right, never mind. Now, wait a minute.
She's saying,
I was just going
to
cut you fellas off, but you opened a can of peas there, Dick.
Yeah, well, close it, would you, Bert?
You left at 4 o'clock in the morning without even a kiss, and you know it.
We didn't kiss.
Richard.
That's right, we didn't kiss, Barbara.
Okay, fellas, moving right along. We'll be back to you in just a moment. You didn't even bother to kiss, huh? Okay. Here comes question number two. Your first date. Same question. Lee, you're up.
Okay.
Tell us about your first date with Greg, Lee.
It could be a very long story, but I'll make it short.
Okay.
Greg called me after we met at a lawn party and asked me if I knew how to play pinochle, and I said yes. And he said, I'd like to take you to a friend's house with his wife, and we'll have a pinochle party. And I said, fine. I didn't know how to play the game, but I learned in 2 days. And we went. We had a fantastic time, and...
And that was it?
That was it, yes.
I've never played pinochle either.
Oh, it's fascinating.
Is it?
It's fantastic. Really? Fantastic game, isn't it? Yes.
I'm sure. Yeah. I'm sure Greg Mars is your partner.
Everybody in the yellow section said, yes, what fantastic game pinochle is. Okay, we need a one or two word clue. It would be pinochle. Okay. Shh, don't give away now. Let's bring on the fellas. All right, gentlemen, we have another question and we have another clue. Actually, it is the same question. Your first date. And the clue is pinochle. Greg.
Oh, boy.
Tell us about it, Greg.
She didn't really tell you this story, did she?
Yes, she did.
Well, to make it short, a friend of mine who eventually became my best man at our wedding asked me one Saturday. He asked me 1 week what I was going to do on Saturday, and I said, I don't know. He said, why don't you get a date, come on over to the house, and we'll play some pinochle. I had met my to-be wife before that, but we had never gone out. And I called her, and I said, do you know how to play pinochle? Well, my wife had never even spelled the word pinochle, but she learned it fast, and she said, yes, I know.
You're right. Thank you, Greg. All right, at this point, Ann and Jerry have yet to score. Lee and Greg and Barbara and Dick are tied with $100 apiece for their winning section. We're going to play a tattletale quickie now. Here it is. Fellas, I'm going to ask you this question, and don't give me the answer until I ask for it, okay? Here's the question first. Men, be honest. And that'll be some difficulty for some of you. Now, which do you think makes a woman more alluring? Total nudity or partial nudity? It says a woman, it doesn't say your wife. It says, be honest. Now, which do you think makes a woman more alluring, total nudity or partial nudity? Think about that. We shall return.
I love to think about this.
Never mind.
Yeah.
See you in a minute, fellas.
Disgusting.
Maybe for you.
Oh, no.
And which one will Jerry say? Will he say partial or total nudity is more alluring?
Well, I think partial. Wait a minute. I know. I think he'll
say partial because sometimes when we make love, we wear funny hats being comedians. Something. A little cologne behind the partial nudity. Uh-huh.
Black stockings and things like
oh,
that.
Oh, yes. What?
So he'll say partial, right?
I hope.
Let's bring him on. All right, Jerry. Which, in fact, do you find makes a woman more alluring, total nudity or partial nudity?
Well, being married to the lady, she would know my preferences. It's got to be partial. I'm glad Anne knows
you
this.
You won the question. What do you have to talk about? That's all.
What, do you want to know who my first crush was?
No,
never mind.
Nobody wants to hear that garbage. What is this? Go to the next one.
All right.
Thank you, Jerry.
Thank
bye.
You. I'm glad we won.
I am too, honey. Good boy.
Oh, Lee, what about Greg? Which one of those will he say?
Partial nudity, of course.
Partial, huh?
Oh, yes.
You sure of that?
Oh, I'm very sure.
Why are you sure of that?
I'm sure because it's like telling your children yes, yes, yes all the time. That doesn't work. Eventually, you'll find out.
Oh.
Sort of saying no, that keeps them in the mainstream.
Yeah.
It keeps things more exciting.
Yeah.
Lee, you're a hussy.
I know what you mean. All right, you silly goose. Let's. you're gonna say partial. Let's bring on Greg.
Shh, don't get away.
All right, Greg, which of those two do you find makes a woman more alluring?
Which of those two what? It's only been a half an hour of birth.
Would you like the choices
question.
Again, sir? The
no,
choices
that's all
are
right.
Partial or total nudity?
No, that's all right. As a friend of mine once said, barbed wire only protects what it shows. I would have to say partial nudity.
Thanks. Of course, you're right only if Lee happens to be wearing barbed wire occasionally.
But it still protects what it shows, baby.
Okay, thanks, Greg. Barbara, how about Dick? What'll he say?
What age are you talking about?
that has nothing to do with the question.
Well, I just meant whether when you're 16 or when you're 23. No, I think partial. Yeah, I think he'll say partial.
He'll say partial. All right, let's bring him on. Shh. All right, Richard, which one do you find most alluring, sir?
I think partial nudity.
That's what I was saying.
At least have the radio on, you know.
She said what?
At least have the radio on.
Yeah, right, okay.
Glasses, braces, I don't care.
We're at the halfway mark now. Ann and Jerry have $100. Lee and Greg, Barb and Dick are tied with $200 apiece. Ladies, if you will, step to the rear. Gentlemen, come on out here. And while we are changing places, we'll break away for a message, but we're coming back. You do that too, please.
Let's Make a Deal Live is on its way. Join us for an all-new version of the classic game show. Like it on TV? You'll love it on stage. Let's Make a Deal Live. For ticket information, go to lmadlive.com.
We are back. We've changed places. I have the gentleman out here with me now, and I use the term unloosely.
What?
No, that means you really are, gentlemen.
Oh, I see. Yeah.
And our studio audience is sharing in the winnings so far, halfway through the show. Everybody is guaranteed going home with some money today. And if you're in the rooting section that is backing our top winning couple, of course, we will add a bonus of $1,000 to that total. You know, do you have any idea how much fun it is to say that? That's fun to say that.
I wish you'd say it to me.
No, I never say it. I never say it to friends. No.
If you lose, you get bus fare home, don't you?
Well, they've already got that. They're already guaranteed. Let's bring on the ladies now and see if they're all set to go, shall we? Ladies, you ready to go?
Yeah. Oh, yes.
Okay, we're going to ask the fellas a question now about themselves and about you and your lives together. And when they have an answer, they're going to press that red button, and then they're going to have a clue ready for you, okay?
Okay.
We'll be back to you in just a minute. Bye, ladies. Gentlemen, ready to go? First question, yeah. Here it is. It happened on the road. Oh, you were fast that time, Jerry. Tell us what happened on the road, sir, if you will.
This happened on the road.
There's a funny echo in here, you know that?
We're all actors on the road, all of us folks, but when something like this happened on the road, you really remember it.
We were playing in Chicago, Ann and myself, in a review before we became Stiller and Mirror. We were just a group of trumpeters.
Well, you were Stiller then.
I was Stiller.
And she was Mirror. Yeah,
that's right. Now, Annie was pregnant in her fourth month, and she always insisted upon working right through because we were broke. And on this particular night, she was singing a song with two other ladies, something happened in that song where what we call in show business breaking up. And she lost control.
Started to laugh
heavily. And as she laughed, something happened. She started to tinkle. Is that the word we use? This really happened. And now the weird part of it now, because I figured the baby was due any second now, because, you know, she had kind of done it. But what happened was I used to follow her on the stage with my song, which was The Old Pizza Maker. And I used to come out singing, a guy returning to the old neighborhood, when you're near that certain corner and you smell that certain smell, it's the old, it's the old. Pizza maker with his crummy mozzarella. Well, anyway, at that point, I noticed a puddle on the stage. I said, this is what's happened to the neighborhood, you know? And I...
Good night, folks. It's been wonderful seeing you. We hope we'll see you again sometime.
I couldn't figure out how that water got on the stage for the life of me.
Right.
Until I looked off in the wings, and there she was, kind of signaling that it's mine, Jerry.
It was hers.
We need a one or two word clue from you, Jerry, that we'll Anne will recognize.
Puddle? Somebody said puddle? All right, the lady over there. I think puddle will make it.
Puddle will do it.
Yeah, puddle will make it, I'm sure.
All right, puddle will be it. Let's bring on the ladies. Ladies, we have a story and we have a clue. Here is the question first. It happened on the road. Okay? The clue is puddle. Well, we have two buzzers. Who is first? Anne was first. Tell us about that.
Who else did this happen to?
I almost said we had two puddles. Tell us about it, if you will, Anne.
I really think you are tasteless, Jerry.
How about you?
I was beyond my control, Bert. I was 3.5 months pregnant with Amy.
And that's the story. That's the story.
Right.
At this point, ladies and gentlemen, we have a tie score. Everybody's tied, $200 apiece. Good close game. We will be right back after a brief commercial message for you. Please come back.
Let's play Guess What's Next. In 1983, after it was on the air for a year, producers introduced a new bonus round called Turnabout. Can you name what's next? Stay tuned. What's up next? If you guess Child's Play, you're right. After a year, producers upped the ante by giving away $5,000 in the new bonus round. Child's Play is next. Stay tuned.
Okay, we're back. We're going to play a tattletale quickie, and we have a tie game. So this will decide it, folks. Ready to go?
Okay.
Ladies, I'm going to ask you the question. As you know, don't give me the answer until we ask for it.
Right.
Ladies, when did you first learn about the birds and the bees? From other kids, from your parents, or from books? The question is, where did you first learn about the birds and the bees? From other kids, from your parents, or from books? Okay, think about it, ladies. What, Anne, you have a question?
Well, we didn't know.
Don't qualify.
All right.
That's the question.
Goodbye.
Where did you first learn about the birds and the bees? Where did you first learn about it? Okay, kids, parents, or books? Go away. We'll come back in a minute. All right. I think we cleared up that confusion. Jerry, what do you think Anne will say?
Well, I know that Anne came from a very staid background, and they would never reveal these important facts, especially if there were birds and bees. But she did learn it in the garage from Sidney Armstrong.
From who?
Sidney Armstrong.
Sidney Armstrong.
He knows who he is. Now, she was about 5 years old, and she used to talk about how Sidney and her and Barbara Nadelman would go into the garage and play doctor together.
Right.
And since Barbara's father, I think, was a doctor, it was all right.
Right. She'd had some training. Yes. Well, she was six.
Yeah, that's something of that. She was ahead of them.
And performed some appendectomies on the stage.
Yes. So you'll say that Anne will say from other kids.
Right, yes.
Okay, let's bring on Anne.
Mm-hmm.
All right, Anne.
Yes.
Where did you first learn about the birds and the bees? From other kids, from your parents, or from books?
About 15 minutes ago. my mother told me, you know, where the baby was.
You!
My mother told me.
That's not what he said. Tell her what you said, Jerry.
What?
You've told me about Sidney Armstrong in the garage.
Well, that was experimental, that's all. My mother said it was all beautiful.
Sorry, Ann, no score there.
You're sorry. Goodbye.
Okay, Greg, how about Lee?
That's funny. Well,
if he says Sidney Armstrong, then we're really in trouble.
Oh, you know, Sidney moved around a lot. Now, well, she came from a kind of cloistered background, and the town in which she lived and grew up was very small, so I don't even think the kids there knew.
Yeah.
She learned to read at an early age, and then she taught me. Yeah. I would say from books.
Books. Okay, let's bring on Lee. Lee, where did you first learn about the birds and the bees? From other kids, parents, or books?
From other kids like Greg and, you know, kids like that.
Sorry, dear. That's not what he said. I'm sorry. He said from books.
Oh, honey.
Sorry about that. Thank you, Lee. No score there. All right, Dick, how about Barbara? What's she going to say?
Barbara learned about sex from a 79-year-old degenerate.
Sidney Armstrong
in the garage.
No, or Sidney.
Other kids.
Other kids. Let's bring on Barbara. Okay, Barbara, where did you first learn about the birds and the bees?
Those country kids didn't take any...
Dick, you have won $300. We add $1,000 to that for a total of $1,300 for your winning ticket. All right. And we shall return with more of Tattletales right after this message for you. Please come back.
There are words...
Eager.
...that lead to other words.
Beaver.
And two other words that are good to know.
No whammies.
They're all words to live by. Super Password and Press Your Luck.
Big bucks.
Big bucks. Big thought you said big,
Weekday starting at noon Eastern, 9 a.m. Pacific. Only on Buzzer. Let's play.
We had a good time today, but we're out of time. So see us next time. Will you, Bert Convy, saying so long for Tyler Payne. Bye, everybody.
This is Jack Clark speaking for Tattletales, a Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production.